Alrighty then. Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Priscilla. Now, I was sent some gouache from Arteza along with a couple of pieces of paper. No, not a couple pieces. Obviously, it says 14 pieces of their cold press paper. So, I have worked with gouache before, but apparently that was not a watercolor-based gouache. The gouache I've worked with before is an acrylic gouache. So, I guess this is like the first time I've ever really worked with this kind of gouache before, because I don't know, it's just, it's different. This is a lot more different to work with, and it's not as difficult as the first set of gouache I've ever worked with. When they reached out to me and they offered to me to pick an art supply, I said, well, I've never really done gouache, right? I use white gouache all the time on my watercolors, but when it came to actually working with just gouache, I thought, oh, well, I better give this a try. And, you know, the experience was really pleasant. I actually follow a lot of gouache artists. It's not that they're specifically gouache artists. One is a specific gouache artist, but the others are just for inspiration. So I follow Perinillarium. I don't know. It's a lot. If I showed you, you guys would know immediately. Butternut gouache, and then Leanna He. She does a lot of really, really cute mermaid gouache paintings, and I always look at her gouache paintings and I think, oh, I wish I was that good at gouache. But my first experience with acrylic gouache was just not that good. I ordered it and I thought, I'm gonna get good at this. So immediately when I started trying out all this Arteza gouache, I started to realize that this is a little bit more manipulative when it comes to water. There's a huge difference between acrylic gouache and then more of a water-based gouache. And as you can see with this illustration of, I am in a huge kick for a 1950s illustration Christmas card kick. I don't know if you guys have noticed the 1950s illustrations, how awesome they are. I actually do my family's Christmas card every year, and I know I'm totally going on a rabbit trail, but I wanted to explain my design for what I was actually drawing. And I asked my mom for this year's Christmas card, can I make a 1950s inspired illustration? She's like, what the heck do you mean? And at the time, I didn't have gouache, or I totally would have used this gouache to make the Christmas card. But what I did was I made it more in a style of 1950s greeting card. Like, if you go on Pinterest and you look up 1950s illustration Christmas cards, then you guys will see this. But I grabbed a lot of inspiration from that. And okay, off the rabbit trail, I just wanted to explain it, and I wanted to include like a llama instead of a reindeer. I thought that would be cute. So that's why I'm doing this particular illustration. Now, I really, 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 really love Arteza's gouache. And I mean, this is probably, yeah, this is the first time I've ever worked with this kind of art supply. I was done wrong. I was just, the acrylic gouache that I worked with a long time ago, it scared me away. It really did. And I was just like, I don't really want to try this again. Do you ever have that where you get to an art supply and you just think, nope, not doing this again? I have done that quite often with a lot of art supplies. And on occasion, from time to time, a digital illustration scares me just because I'm not good at it. And I want to get better at it, but then I thought, oh, I gotta push myself. I have to actually try. I really, really, after giving gouache a second try, when this company Arteza reached out to me and they said, hey, pick an art supply, and I saw that, and I looked at the gouache on their list of items, and I thought, I guess I'll give this a try, since I've tried basically everything else, and I just really want to give it one more shot. Basically, after researching a ton, I wanted to really know what's the I don't have my acrylic gouache anymore to actually compare this gouache to. This is a watercolor gouache, this Arteza brand. And then I looked up what is acrylic gouache and what's the difference. Apparently, acrylic gouache is essentially acrylic paint. And when you, it's just treated like a gouache. So it comes out looking the same. But I feel like the, just by reading all this, that the watercolor is a lot more manipulative. And just by adding water to it, you get more of a watercolor finish. If you're a watercolor artist and you realize that when you add water to watercolor, then you realize you're more able to make different shades by adding different layers, the same color that you keep putting on top and top and top keeps adding layers, but it's still a really cool matte finish. So it's nothing shiny to it. It's just, it's got a really solid finish. It kind of reminds me of like not having that many layers on a painting. Let's say if you're making a painting and you have a really thick single layer and you want it to be as thick as possible, and then you come in and you line it later. Instead of adding layer on top of layer or adding different colors on top of those layers to give it more of shading and highlights, you just have that one single layer. And that's, I don't know if that makes sense at all. It's so difficult to explain, but that's how I feel about this gouache. And I don't know, just look at the way that it looks. It definitely, it doesn't look like acrylic paint, and then it doesn't look like watercolor. And I was still, and you see, I do have layers on it, but it's just like, the colors and the layers that I added to add shading and highlights, it complements each other, but it has a matte finish. So it doesn't look anything like acrylic paint, and it doesn't look like watercolor. And that's what I really like about this. And I'm definitely going to keep using this now that I actually like it, because I've been into watercolor for the last month just because I wanted to get back into it. And now that I have this new toy from Arteza, I'm just so excited. So if you guys want to check out Arteza's brand of this gouache, I really like it. I'll leave the link down below. And thank you, Arteza, for sending me gouache and let me have another go at it. I really, really enjoyed working with this art supply once again. It's always good to revisit those fears of art supply, so never be too afraid to approach art supply that scared you so much. It's a challenge, but if you give it a try one more time, then you might just fall in love with it. Yeah, I'm gonna keep using this gouache. I think I'm gonna go make another Christmas doodle. I'll see y'all later. Bye!